I expect this kind of game. First of all, Utena Juventus have a very good team. I know them, even as coach of AEK, we play against them in Champions League. They have some big wins this season, and I was really afraid of this game because, you know, I know how the players think after these two wins, and exactly this happened first half. We were slow. Utena, they have average 90 points per game. You know, this is mean if you want to stop them, you must really play hard team defense. But it was terrible. And you can see from the shots what we've made, all the shots were short. This is mean they was not ready for the game. They can find excuses, tiredness, blah, blah, but no, this is our job. Second half, and also because we don't play defense, the referee call every contact, you know, it's a lot of basket and fouls and et cetera, et cetera. Second half was much better. We grow up with the defense. We also make better decisions and in offense, and we start scoring again because we start to play defense, you know, and it's very simple. And in the end, you win, you know, with this difference, but I couldn't relax until, you know, 3 minutes until the end, and it was really hard game for me, like a coach. We won, and, you know, everything is okay, but it's not.
Sveikinu žaidėjus, tai nebuvo lengvos rungtynės, tokių ir tikėjausi, nes Utenos komanda yra tikrai gera ekipa, esu prieš ją rungtynėvis čempionų lygoje, jį pastaruoju metu gerai žaidė ir žinau, šiek tiek bijau, kad po dviejų pergalių gali būti tokios sunkios rungtynės mums, pirmoje pusėje taip ir buvo, buvome per lėti. Turėjome žaisti kietai, tačiau to nebuvo, buvo prasta gynyba, tuo tarpu polime visi metimai buvo trumpi ir tikrai turėjome būti geriau pasiruošę. Antroje pusėje visų pirma susitvarkė gynyba, tada ir polime pavyko įmesti, tapo sprendimai geresni ir skirtumas neparodo buvusios kovos, nes likus dar 3 minutėm atrodė, kad rungtynės dar nėra baigtas.
Good week for you, coach. 3 victories in a row. I guess that that was very important for self-confidence of all the players and for you personally, maybe. What about that? How do you rate this 3 victories and the importance of for players and for you personally?
Well, sure, they're important. I mean, but it automatically give you more responsibility, you know, because I know the players when, you know, when they're losing, they are tight, they are serious, they try to, you know, but when they start winning, they relax, you know. And this, you know, sometimes make me even more nervous when we have winning strike to because, you know, you must, it's your job not just to coach them, prepare, I mean, tactically, you also must push them, you know, to be ready for every game. Also, we, you know, it's all, sometimes it's easy with the some practices to come on the some level of defensively, you know, but it's more difficult to keep this level, you know, to, you know, like you go on the hill, you know, the last 10 meters is most difficult. And what is the most difficult is to stay on the top. And this is the coaches when the season start and start winning is the most difficult job. For sure, it's, you know, we with this 3 win we get some confidence, like you said. Also, I start to feel the team a little bit, the players, you know, how they think, how they react in different situations, who play with who good, you know. But you know, it's every day it's a new challenge for me, and normally every game is new challenge, and this is how is our job.
Klausimas buvo, kiek svarbu yra šios trys pergalės komandos pasitikėjimui. Žinoma, kad svarbu, tačiau automatiškai tai priduoda ir daugiau atsakomybės, nes kaip pralaimi žaidėjai būna susikaupę, šiek tiek įsitempę, o laimint dažnai būna, kad komanda gali ir atsipalaiduoti, todėl man darbo nėra mažiau, turiu juos pastumti. Taip pat, kaip lipant į kalną, paskutiniai 10 metrų turbūt būna sunkiausia, tai ir mums reikia išlaikyti tą lygį, su darbu siekti, kad jis būtų dar geresnis. Tačiau taip įgyjome pasitikėjimo ir tuo pačiu dar pavyko man pajausti daug labiau žaidėjus, kas su kuo gerai žaidžia. Tai kiekviena diena yra naujas iššūkis.
Talking about personalities, Tyler Cavanaugh is playing much better at the moment, a few games in a row, not just in the LKL, but also in the EuroLeague. Coach, what are the main keys of his improvement now?
I will say a little joke now, maybe because their parents are here, you know. Okay. The last three games, parents come and they bring him, also us, let's say luck, you know. But look, Tyler is very serious, you know. I mean, he is all day in the gym, he practice, he work individual, he try to improve his game, he listen, and I really, I mean, it's pleasure for me to have this kind of players. Normally he's not, we know their weaknesses also, you know, but he want to improve, we want to hide something, but again, you know, he give really every moment when he step on the court 100%.
Klausimas buvo apie Tylerį Kaunų ir jo pagerėjusį žaidimą. Tai pradėsiu gal nuo juoko, kad jo tėvai yra atvykę čia į Lietuvą ir atnešė mums tas tris pergalės. O jeigu kalbant rimtai, tai Tyleris tikrai rimtai dirba, tiek treniruosiuose, tiek visą laiką ateina papildomai padirbėti salėje, nori tobulėti. Jis žino, kokių silpnų vietų turi ir tiesiomis dirba, kad jas pagerintų, ištaisytų.
And sorry, we also put him on five, you know, and you know, in this position he can get some easy shots to maybe, you know, to get easy to the rhythm, you know, and from this point when we start to put him on five, we every time we get something, you know, even the last game against Fener, you know, we have some problem in offense, you know, and we score immediately. And he gave us also this option.
Taip pat pastumus į penktąją poziciją atsiranda papildomų opcijų, jisai gali galbūt lengviau įsivesti kai kurios metimus.
41 points in the last quarter, what does that say about your team's offensive potential?
Look, I will not, I mean, let's say that Utena stopped to play defense, you know, I mean, we really find the open man very easy. They have not a lot of players there, a lot of veterans, they get tired, you know. And I will not really now. But we find the we know we what we practice actually we with this we attack them and we kick the pass from the paint outside, you know, this is high percentage shots because you get the ball on the chest, like on the practice when you're shooting, you know. And we score, you know, everything, but I mean, these are spot up shots, you know, they are high percentage and but again, I believe that everything happened because we start to play defense, we score some easy baskets, you know, and after this pressure from their back, you know, go down and they relax and they scoring.
Klausimas buvo apie 41 tašką ketvirtame kėlinyje ir Žalgirio puolimo potencialą. Utena šiek tiek nustojo gintis, todėl rasdami visus žmonės, nes varžovai pavargo. Tuo pačiu sugebėjome įvykdyti, ties kuo dirbame treniruotėse, tai kai perdavimai iš baudos aikštelės būna į išorę, tai tokie metimai yra būtent tokie, kurios žaidėjai meta treniruotėse. Tačiau svarbu pažymėti ir gynybą, nes apsiginus kelis kartus ir užpuolus tiesiog dingo įtampa, kas ir padėjo puolime.
After the game you said that this match against Juventus was harder than the match against Fenerbahce. Why do you think so?
Well, I already start in the beginning, you know. First of all, you know, the motivation of the players is completely different. I say in the first half, after first half, I see two different teams against Fenerbahce, you know. It's almost full gym, everybody fly, the bench, jump, you know, support. First half this game, you know, nobody don't talk in the court, on the bench, you know, white faces, no emotions, you know. And I tried to put some emotion on this game, and for me it was really, really tough how to wake them up, how to find the way from this terrible first half, you know, to come to the win.
Klausimas buvo, treneris buvo minėjęs, kad šios rungtynės sunkesnės nei su Fenerbahce, kodėl. Tai tiesiog motivacija buvo skirtinga. Rungtynėse su Fenerbahce pilna arena, visi skraido, suolas užsivedęs, palaiko komandą. Šiandien pirmoje pusėje matome, kad visi tylūs, balti veidai. Todėl man tikrai reikėjo pažadinti komandą antroje pusėje.
And the last question from me, coach, looking to the next week, you are going to Barcelona to play versus Zalgiris fans idol Šarūnas Jasikevičius and his strong Barca. Do you see some real possibilities to find some weak signs of Barca and to reach a victory against them?
For sure. I mean, we go every game to win. We play good now. We get some confidence. I didn't honestly work on Barca yet. To find the weak spot, for sure they have some weak spot, but you know, even tonight, you know, what you need to play good defense, you know, this is first, if you concentrate on the weak spot, I don't really believe, you know, that we have this quality to punish them like tonight, you know. Now we need now to focus how to attack Gečevičius because he's weak defender, you know, I mean. And don't really believe on this, that this can be the key, you know, to win the game, you know. You can normally, you know, because we still don't have quality to read the game, you know, and during the game the players to see what's going on, you know, and to punish this, I don't know, switching or where they stay, how they switch, you know. But look, it's 40 minutes game, you know, and I like to say, in the end of the day, even if they have a good roster, it's just 5 players on the court, you know, it's not 12 players, you know. And we also have now, Nils will still not be back, you know. It's also important players for us, especially because, you know, we have just three guys in the pain. Okay, Reggie come, but he's still, you know, I don't believe he will be ready. But we have enough, let's say, big roster now to hopefully nobody will not get COVID or injured until Thursday. How lucky we are, yeah. Everything can happen. We have a big roster that we can find the you know, to play with the high rhythm, you know, to and normally if to beat Barcelona, you must really have, let's say, 9-10 players on very good day, you know, but hopefully they will be motivated. I have no doubt about this, you know, and we'll try.
Klausimas buvo, ar yra galimybių veikti gerai žaidžiančio Barcelona kitą savaitę. Žinoma, visose rungtynėse mes einame kovoti dėl pergalės. Turime visų pirma žaisti gerai gynyboje, o ne galvoti, kad galėsime atakuoti, sakykime, vieną žaidėją, ieškodami varžovų silpnų pusių. Tiesą sakant, dar ties šiomis rungtynėmis nedirbau. Tačiau, kalbant bendrai, tai visų pirma turime skaityti žaidimą. Rungtynės vyksta 40 minučių ir žaidžia aikštelė vienu metu 5 žaidėjai, o ne 12. Tai reiškia, kad nors Barcelona turi gerą sudėtį, tačiau kovosime būtent 5-5, o iš mūsų pusės, žinoma, šiek tiek trūks Nilso Gifai, kurio dar nebus kitą savaitę, tačiau turime dabar treniruotės jis tiek daugiau žaidėjo, nors Regimantas Minutas dar galbūt ir nebus pasiruošęs. Tačiau tuo pačiu tikimės, kad žinant mūsų sėkmę nieko neatsitiks iki rungtynių, tai turime pasiruošti būtent čia mačui ir kovoti dėl pergalės.